everybody. I'm Gabriel Gordon. I am the orchestra director here at Syracuse Arts Academy. And what you see before you is Orchestra One again. And when last we met our heroes in Orchestra One, they had just started to use their bows and were still playing quarter notes in, you know, nice Christmas-like tunes, okay? We have since added some really, really interesting and more difficult techniques for what they're going to do. Today you're going to hear half notes as well as eighth notes, and being able to divide the beat in that way is one of the most essential things that you can learn as a musician. So they are really building a great foundation for becoming great players. The first tune that we're going to play has some of that in it, and it's called Grandparents' Day for you grandparents out there. And as you may or may not have heard as well, that featured a skip, which we hadn't been able to do before, where we went from the open string to the second finger. And that's also kind of a very difficult dexterity thing that we're always practicing. I was practicing my skips just this morning myself. So the next piece that we're going to play was, until fairly recently, the longest play piece that we had ever played, so we're building stamina as well. And it features rests at the beginning, okay, so it starts on the third beat, and it has a repeat in it where there's a first ending where we play one version of the song, and then when we repeat, we go back and we go to the second ending, and that also increases the eye coordination as well as the hand. This is Michael Row You Row to Shore. So again, you know, if you've ever been reading a book
yourself, geez, I'd like to go back to that other part that I was just reading, and it kind of, like, it's hard to find. Musicians have to do that on a regular basis, where we instantly find what we were doing before on the repeat, and then we have to play it, and that's actually kind of hard to coordinate. The next piece we're going to play is also another familiar tune, Farajaka, and it actually features the first time that we're using the fourth finger, as well as all the other fingers, and it features half notes, it features eighth notes, it's pretty much all the techniques that we've been working on, and I've been told that I have to say that it is, Farajaka is actually about a chef making a chicken, and that's kind of a funny thing about it. In case some of you noticed as well, I was actually conducting a slightly different beat pattern for that one. So that was the first time that we went away from 4-4 and went into 2-4 beat pattern. That's two quarter notes in a measure rather than four quarter notes in a measure. So that was also brand new for us. The last piece that we're going to perform for this orchestra is one of my absolute favorites. It's the tune from Beethoven's Ninth Symphony, Ode to Joy, and it is by far the most difficult as well as the longest piece that we've ever played. It's always literally such a joy to hear this song. So I hope you all enjoy it. Okay, and now we're introducing the Syracuse Arts Academy. Orchestra too. Let's give them a hand. Okay, so this program is called Dance Around the World, and we're going to be playing various dances from various different parts of Europe, and as well as our final piece is from Ukraine, but also here in the United States. All the different ways in which dance is exemplified in our literature. So the first one we're going to do is played every New Year's Eve in Germany and Austria. It's called the Radetzky March, and it is celebrating the victory by General Radetzky of, you know, a great battle that he won. And apparently, according to tradition, the soldiers were actually singing the folk tune that occurs in the second section here, and so that's why Johann Strauss included in here. I'd like to thank Mr. Whipple and our winds, brass, and percussion section that we have added for the first two pieces on the program. Let's give them a hand, please. You can't really have a Radetzky march without a snare drum. So I'm very, very grateful. Thank you.
Okay, so we are going from Germany and Austria over to Paris, where they are having a whole lot of fun dancing the can-can from the piece Orpheus in the Underworld. And everybody's very, very familiar with this tune, the can-can, of course. But I'm sure many of you don't know that it actually comes from the opera, Orpheus in the Underworld. And Orpheus, the tale of Orpheus is this really sad one where, you know, Orpheus is the great musician of Greece, and his wife dies, and he decides to go to Hades, and he plays for Hades, and Hades says, okay, I'll give you your wife back, but you can't turn around, and he ends up turning around and loses her forever, and it's a very, very sad story. And this opera has almost absolutely nothing to do with that story. They're just having a really, really good time in Paris, and you can hear it. Thanks again, Winds and Brass. Thank you. Let's give them a hand. The percussion. Okay, so we travel now from Paris to the United States, probably somewhere around here, okay, where we have Fiddles on Fire. Thank you. Okay, and for our final piece on the program, you know, when I found this, it was just kind of fortuitous. I had already decided that this was going to be a Dance Around the World program, and I saw this, and it was a Hoback, which can be from actually several different places, but then it said, you know, Ukrainian folk song, and I said, oh, you know, what a way to remind ourselves of, you know, what's happening in the world and what we can do to alleviate it. And I can guarantee you that there are many Ukrainians today, for all the things that they are going through, some of them are still dancing at times. And that's actually my most fervent hope. This is the Hopek from Ukrainian folk song.
Good evening, parents. I know you've already been a good evening to death already, so. Hello, and welcome to our third term concert. Our band one is now on stage with some help from some of our advanced band members, Nicole, Eli, Brandon, Carly over there on bass guitar. We'll be joined by Abby Laws on piano. I want to thank you for being here tonight. I know it's hard to be not outside with this super warm spring we're having. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I think I told you guys last time how smart I was, right? I got rid of my snowblower this last summer, thinking I'd never need it again. Yeah, it's my fault. I've been blamed several times, so. So hopefully, if you were a band one parent, if you recorded their first concert, hopefully you had a chance to listen to it or listen to it after you hear them. Hopefully you hear that mark, just amazing improvement these students have made from term one to term two to term three. We got four songs for you, as you see on the program. We're going to start with Rockin' Rockin'.
One, two, three, four.
Students are helping us out. Nicole on Barry, Eli and Brendan on tuba, back here again. Carly, who plays on our girls basketball team, who took down the only undefeated team earlier today. Very nice girls basketball.
Yeah.
Mount Ogden. All right. We'll see them in the playoffs again, I'm sure. Thank you. So keeping in a little bit of theme with yesterday's dancing choir concert, which was amazing. If you were here, you know, you witnessed it. music from around the world, but this next one is, are you saying it? Yes, or Spanish March. The final song that band one did, Byzantine Dances, is from an ancient empire in Eastern Europe as well. And then the first song we played, of course, Western. And then, what's our final song? I can't even remember.
321.
That's as American as apple pie right there. Sorry, I'm just killing time. Give them a minute. Progression good? Almost? Parents of the students on stage, especially those who are ninth graders, they're coming up to their final concert next term, which is mind-boggling to me every year. So for those parents who've been with it for 3 years, thank you so much for all that you've done for these students as well. I'm always amazed when that May comes. It's like, oh wait, you're a high schooler? you're a young adult. It's amazing to me. I'm so lucky that I get to see these students grow from seventh graders and see who they become as ninth graders. It's pretty awesome to see. Where some teachers only get to see them for a semester there, I get to see that, not just growth in musicianship and knowledge, but who they start to become as citizens of our community here, community of our school, and who they're becoming as young adults as they move on to high school, stuff like that. It's really fun to see, I mean, even though it is sad to see them go, but we are just, and I tell them this all the time, we're a stepping stone. And they'll, sometimes I hear students say, oh, we're gonna come back and say hi, and I say, no. By December, you won't even remember our names. Move forward on to bigger, better things. So I want to thank all those parents, especially the ones who've been here repeatedly. I think they may have mentioned a couple names at the beginning, Mr. Hirakawa Gardner, and who else was it? Oh, yeah, Ms. Steele as well. So they've been coming here for like, it feels like 10 years. So thank you so much. I don't know. Let me face this way. Thank you. Thank you, Ruth. Well, this has been a hard-working group this term, learning a bunch of extra songs that they got to play for our junior high dance, which was a whole lot of fun. And if you have a chance, you need to go on there, onto Facebook, onto the Syracuse Arts Academy page, and check out the coolest tambourine player you'll ever see. Yes. Who saw that already? Did you see that already? Oh. Ruth Fortinson, it may be the coolest tambourine player of all time. I watched that probably about 20 times. Smiled every single time. It was amazing. But I want to thank these students. They learned so much extra music, threw stuff away. It's been one of the busiest terms we've ever had here. And on top of that, learning some very difficult numbers, which you're going to hear the first two. We have 88 Avenue. Who's soloing in 88 Avenue first? We got Hannah on piano, Grant, and then we have trumpet soli. It's Jay and Cam that are going to be playing the trumpet solo.
One, two, one, two, three.
Our next song features soloists Natalie, who else? Oliver, and Jude. Okay. I'll find my way around here. Nope, you're all good, man. We just need a smaller stage. Well, it wasn't a problem 10 years ago. It was only 15 students. It's your fault, really. Signing up for the bus. Now it's awkward guitar wave moment. They do such a good job. They're like ants crawling over you. You saw the percussion moving back and forth. I'm always amazed that like they're able to work so well together, switch things around. It's the coolest thing in the world. I want to thank them for that. And if I don't say thank you enough, just imagine me saying it every day too, because it's really cool. This song also features Hunter Roberts on bass. A little bit of a solo by Jacob here at the beginning. Who, by the way, who's forced to be here tomorrow for the guitar concert? Yeah. Wait till you see Jacob. Hear Jacob tomorrow.
Oh, yeah. Jacob.
He's going to be the littlest white rapper of all time.
Yeah.
Okay, great. Thank you.
You said it right there. That was right. Again, thank you again, parents, for being here tonight, administration, tech. Really appreciate it. Those who have to be here three nights in a row, thank you. I think the administration will be providing some kind of beverage for you tomorrow. I think they said something like that. He laughs, but he knows. If there are any band students left in here, when we get done, we do need to take everything back. If everybody just comes and grabs one or two things, we can get it back real fast. I want to thank these students on stage so much. It's so much fun to be up here and just listen and enjoy the music they're creating. I tell them all the time, you're not just playing black dots on a white page anymore. You're sounding like musicians. It's sounding like music. It's a great thing. It's a wonderful job to have every day. Let's give these students one more round of applause, please. Okay, last number. Who's soloing this one? I can't remember. We got Corbin, Brody, and Luke in the back. All right. Can you take a guess how many Lukes are in this class right now? Three. Lukes, raise your hand.
Hi.
Your parents must be Star Wars fans. All right, here we go.